Betty's Kitchen. Yesterday, Rick and I went on a little field trip, and you were able to go along if you happened to watch our video. It was the trip to the restaurant called the Glitz at Irish Acres, and we both had a wonderful lunch, and I told you that one of the items in our lunch would be what I would choose to make for you, and I've chosen today to make the cream of broccoli soup. So that's what we're starting with, and before I actually start making the soup, I want to tell you that there were lots of beautiful antiques at Irish Acres, and we went through all of the rooms, although there's no way to see all of the antiques at one time, but I did go ahead and get videos of those, and I have three videos of antiques. I'll probably upload one of those. Maybe all of them, but I will entitle them so you will know that there is no recipe and it's only for antique lovers, because you would be very bored if you're not interested in antiques. But I tell you, they are very beautiful, and you might be surprised at what you would see at Irish Acres. But that's where we had our lunch, in their restaurant, the Glitz, and it was a wonderful lunch. We had different items to eat mostly, and we both enjoyed it tremendously. So this is my selection, cream of broccoli soup, that I'm going to give you as an example. And it's not their recipe, it's my recipe for cream of broccoli soup, and I hope you enjoy it. We start with one box of chopped broccoli. Now, this is just enough probably for Rick and me. I try not to overdo it. Double everything in the recipe if you're going to need to feed several people. Because actually I took my recipe and cut it down in order to get this one so that Rick and I wouldn't overeat. But I have some water over here on the stove, and you need maybe a quarter cup, half cup, or if you go in inches, maybe a half inch to an inch, and you get it to a boil. It's back to a boil now, and you put your frozen chopped broccoli in, and then of course it's going to take it away from boiling, so you might want to turn the heat up just a little bit, quickly bring it back to boiling, and then it will need to cook for maybe 6 to 8 minutes. So I'll have to go away and get my chopped broccoli cooked. I'll drain it and I'll have it ready to go in our soup. My chopped broccoli is cooked. You can see it. It's been drained through this colander, and I'm going to just put it in this pot, and that's where we're going to stir together our soup. So this is nice and cooked. It took about 7 minutes after it came to a boil. So you're going to add some milk. And what I have is 1 1/3 cups. And this is skim milk. This is going to be a fairly fat-free, well, not fat-free, but it's going to be a low-fat soup. Now, cream of anything soup sounds very fatty, and my actual recipe that I have is for 1 cup of milk and then 1/3 cup of heavy cream. But I'm not doing that. I'm just doing 1 1/3 cups of milk. So we'll put that in. Actually, for me, there's very little difference in the taste, and there will be a little less creaminess, but we're putting some mushroom soup in. This is just your regular 10 3/4 ounce condensed mushroom soup. That gives it some creaminess. So I think we can get by with just milk there. And that saves a lot of fat, because when you're dealing with heavy cream, it's just like butter as far as fat is concerned. Next, we're going to put in some butter. And I have 1 1/2 tablespoons that I have melted. I just did it in the microwave. You have to watch, it will pop a lot, so you can cover it. But I just use the low power setting. So that goes in. 1 1/2 tablespoons melted butter. And then we have a few spices out here in the end, or herbs. This is tarragon. It goes really well with this dish. And what I have is 1/4 teaspoon. I'm going to put that in my hand and crush it just a little bit to release those flavors, and then let it go into the blend. And then I have some black pepper. This would be maybe a dash or an eighth of a teaspoon. And we'll put that in. And that's all we're going to put in right now. Now, after stirring all of this together, it's really ready to take back to the stove and heat up. That's if you like your soup chunky like this. Then this is a nice cream of broccoli soup. And how easy is that to make? It's done except for needing a little bit of heating because it's still a little warm. The milk cooled it down some. Just heat it back up, but don't boil it. What I'm going to try to do is make it look a little more like what I ordered at the Glitz. Theirs was pureed, so it was more like a bisque. So I have my blender out here, so I'm going to go away and get this poured in, and then we will puree that. Then we'll take it to the stove, back in this pot again, and heat it up, and it'll be ready to eat. My cream of broccoli soup is ready to puree, and you might notice I've done a little bit with it already. I've poured the soup mixture into my blender, and you'll notice that it has a nice green color. I put 3 drops of green food coloring in. That's optional, and that's just for looks, make it a little more appetizing. If you don't like to do that, then just leave that out. But what I'm going to do is set this on puree, it is, and then turn it on, which I'll do in just a second. When it's all completely pureed to my satisfaction, then I will pour it back in the pot that it came from. It will go back to the stove and we'll heat it to boiling, but it will not let it bubble. We'll just at that point serve it up. So I'm going to turn it on here and be back to serve it up to you soon. My cream of broccoli soup has just come to a boil. You do not want to boil your soup. So here's what it looks like when it's in the pot. And I'm going to take a soup bowl and just ladle some in there. See what it looks like when it gets pureed. If you prefer the chunkier, remember you can stop at that point and heat it to boiling and then serve from there. Let's do one more ladle. Doesn't that look nice? And then I'm bringing it over to my plate where I have some butter crackers. You can use any type of cracker that you like. I think I had some butterfly shaped butter crackers at the Glitz. And then there was a sprinkling, I think, of paprika over the top, but my recipe calls for nutmeg, so I'm just going to sprinkle a little nutmeg over the top here. And theirs might have been nutmeg too, I can't really say because the lighting, it was very nice and a little bit romantic, but I could not tell from the color whether it was paprika or nutmeg, and I didn't really taste the nutmeg taste, so I thought maybe it's paprika. Over here for my drink, you'll see I got out the goblet that Rick and I purchased at Irish Acres Antique Gallery, and I really love it. I think I'll enjoy drinking my tea from it.